get worried, and your load is hard to bear, and your life is like a sad, sad story, and no one, nobody really cares. But if you ever need someone to talk to, and if you ever need a helping hand, I'll be your ship out on the ocean. I'll be your water in the desert sand. I felt like you do, feeling like winter will never turn to spring. And everybody I know has got problems, but there's a solution to everything. And if you ever need someone,
yeah, 527 Whitney Avenue, the home of a Common Ground Collective. Oh, this is New Orleans. Algiers is the section, but it's in the city of New Orleans.
Okay.
And this is a place that we are dedicating to the only volunteer in the aftermath of Katrina to lose her life. Her name is Meg Perry. And Meg was a 24-year-old young lady from Maine who came down here in the aftermath of Katrina on a veggie bus. It runs strictly off of used vegetable oil that she would pick up on the route from Maine to New Orleans. She came down here twice, and each time she brought not only supplies, but individuals that that truly made an impact when nobody else was doing nothing. We talking about a young white lady that was basically working in some of the most hardest hit African-American communities in the city of New Orleans. And she was on her way to offer the same type of services to the home Indians. This was a person that truly transcend color or race. She was the essence of what America is supposed to be about. It was just so sad the way that she was killed. That same bus turned over and crushed her. And I guess the most heart-wrenching part of it is the city of New Orleans never even recognized her. They basically classified her as a drifter. And she was just a drifter that was killed here. Nothing was said about the sacrifices that she had made. And I know maybe if she had died working for another organization, you know, that maybe she would have been treated with some form of dignity. But because she was working with us, you know, she was just classified as a drifter. It's been 4 years since her death. I believe that she needed to be recognized for the sacrifice that she had made to our community. And by that, I mean to the African-American community in the aftermath of Katrina. Also to the city that I love. It here. The whole environmental process, our bioremediation program, our wetland and our parks program. Meg worked on them all. She topped roofs when nobody else was topping any roofs. I mean, putting temporary coverings on houses. But anywhere that she seen the need, she was there. I would like to dedicate this building in her honor and have our official ceremony for the Meg Perry Center for Environmental Peace and Justice. It's sad that we're a nation, you know, that believe in incarceration, you know, instead of rehabilitation. We have to break this unholy dependency upon incarceration as the only solution to crime. You know, that we got to do something to help ourselves. We are saying that it's time for us not to look at just jobs, but look at how can we invest and start our own businesses. So at Common Ground Relief, Common Ground Health Clinic, or 501c3s, so they can only get so far involved in the social aspects of our community, or the political. But this is not a 501c3. You know, no one can dig us out of it. You know, they can help us, but we have to take the effort to dig ourselves out of it. Well, the kitchen, where we're at now, is a place that we are looking at to really deal with our economic development. Because one thing New Orleans is known for is music and food. So we're going to capitalize on the food. We have some of the best cooks. Sad to say that most of them have also been to prison. And with many of them, they learn how to cook for thousands in prison. We want to unite them right here. We want to unite them under what we will call the National Gumbo Connection, you know, and with that we'll be catering throughout the country, you know, on specializing in Louisiana cuisine and bringing about awareness of the plight of the ex-offender here in Louisiana. Here's will be the beginning of our economic development, and that's in construction. You know, right now in New Orleans, you know, there's a great need for construction. But in many cases, we are dealing with individuals that have the skills, but they don't have the tools. So we're gonna try to unite the skills and tools, and together we are trying to work toward building the economic base that we can cover the bonding and the insurance, and we're going to put people to work. We're going to build houses for ourselves. ¶¶